Hey guys, this is Final 11, also known as Kuro 11 on YouTube. And yeah, this is my first Y Schwartz related post in quite a while, actually. Ever since I cracked open the booster extra pack 2 for Angel Beats. And today I have a deck profile of my current Angel Beats deck. It's still not done, but it's almost there. It's close to getting finished. Just have to wait for the cards to come in and the deck would be done. So let's get started. So for grade zeros, or I mean level zeros, Vanguard Terms, I have two TK Horrible at English. Oh yeah, if you see, for the sake of everyone related, for sake of everyone, I have the English translation slips inside the card sleeves. This is so it makes the game more accessible to get new players, because I'm trying to build a new player base where I live. And it makes it simple for everyone that way. Even though I am learning how every card works in my decks, so yeah. Anyway, back to the card. Two TKs, Horrible at English. They're just your basic 0-0, 500 assist card. They're just essentially placeholders until I get the 1-0 Kanade that gives a death character's hand encore. So, I could have done better, but I like this card. I like this card a lot. Mainly because it's TK, and TK is awesome. Next cards I have is two Otonashi Beating Memories, which they bond for Messenger of God Tenchi. This is a very useful card. It gets me back one of the key cards of the deck, which I will show when I get to the level 1. Put this aside. Next, I have two Kanade Operation Meeting. When I have one or fewer other characters, it gains plus 1000 power and Hand Encore. What I mean by Hand Encore is that during your Encore step, you can discard a card instead of paying the 3 stop. Very, very useful card early game. When you have like no characters play, it becomes 35 and it stays alive. That's all it does. It's a really useful card. Really good level 0. Yep. Next up is 2 Yuri Invitation to the Battlefront. They serve the same purpose as a Kanade Operation Meeting. 3.5k beaters, except has a condition which is usually fails, which is good. Its effect is when it's placed from the hand to the stage, reveal the top card of my library. If it's not a death character, put it in your clock. This card is really interesting in the fact that early game you can just summon it. Reveal the top card, it's the death character, obviously. All the characters in this deck are death. And she just survives and I don't take damage. But certain games, interesting situations came up where I played her at level 0, reveal the top card, ended up it was a climax or an event, put it in my clock, leveled up to level 1, and just went to town with all the level 1s in my hand. So a really interesting card, very useful. It's good. It's a good card. Next, I have 2-0-0 Kanade Student Council Presidents. Effect is when it becomes reversed while battling, I may pay the cost, and it just searches for one student council character. And she sends herself to memory, which is kind of relevant. Not really. She's just your basic searcher card. Utility. Nothing more, nothing less. And I think my final two cards are pretty important. They are the 0-0 Yuri Suiciders. This card, when this card, characters opposite this card cannot side attack against it. And second effect is the suicide effect. Really good one for one against your opponent level 0 characters. Very, very good early game. Late game, eh. It becomes clock fodder, level up fodder. And, yeah. I should get more of these, actually. Pretty expensive, though. Don't mind me, I'm, like, currently recovering from a cold. Alright. Put that in the back. Next up, I have my level 1s. Okay, so I have two Operation Tornado. Its effect is Brainstorm, reveal the top three cards in my library, put them into the waiting room, choose a level X or lower death character, where X equals the amount of death characters revealed. This card is good. It's free. It's essentially a free card at level 1. It helps for deck compression, just getting me closer to refresh when just getting me closer to refresh, and it's essentially a salvage card. Since this deck usually runs on level 1s, it's just revealing one death card, really good. Revealing one death card, putting it back to your hand, pretty good effect. Next I have one Canadian Yuri Allied Front. This is basically another salvage card. I put one card to clock and I salvage a card from my graveyard to my hand, or waiting room to my hand. Sorry. Good. It's good. Salvage does what it does. Another free card. 1/0. Oops. Utility. Good. Good card. Good card is good. Next, I have Kanade Angel Wings from the new Booster Pack 2. It gains 500 power for each other death characters I have on stage, and it has a climax effect. If I play the climax card, Time of Farewell, pay cost, and search my deck. It's a good card. I haven't really gotten the chance to use the... Whoops, wrong pile. Haven't gotten a chance to use the climax combo often. But when it does, it's good. I can search for a counter, so... Yeah, well... Yeah, I can search for a counter. But... I don't have any student console counters in my deck. Oh well. It's still a good card. I like it. I might switch it out for another Brainstormer though, but who knows. Next up, Kanade End of Opposition. Gains 1k power during my turn, and Brainstorm. Reveal the top 4 cards in my library, put them in the waiting room. For every climax card revealed that way, choose one character. It gains 2k power for the turn. This card is good. For the Brainstorm, like a deck compression. It actually got me out of several situations where I had to punch over something bigger than my cards. It gave it that little extra boost that made a punch over. Next up I have Yuri Daunting Gaze. Another Brainstormer card, but instead of giving a power boost, it salvages a card. Salvage is always good. Always good. Getting back that one card you need, puts it back in your hand. Always good. Next, I have 4 Messenger of God Tenchi. She is the key card of the deck. 7.5k for 1/1. What an effect that's usually... that you will usually never go off. The effect is, when it's placed on the stage, like the top of my library, if it's not a death character, she goes into the waiting room at the beginning of the encore step. She is really good. At most games, you use, with her out, she can put the pressure from putting your opponent from level 1 to level 3. And because just she's so powerful, you will stay at level 1, no problems. She is really good. And if you have multiples out, you can play one, reveal the top card. If it's a death character, drop the rest. Get a field of 7.5Ks. I don't recommend doing that. You overextend. Bad idea. Unless you're just going straight 1-for-1s with your opponent. Which is good. Good. Awesome card. Maybe I should invest in some foils. Next up is 1 Angel's Mambo Tofu. It's another search card for my deck. I put it in there for utility. I might want to take it out. Every time I use it, it hasn't really paid off. It's just there for utility. I don't know how long this is going to stay in the deck though. I just like the card. Mambo Tofu. And last is my counters, 3, the song they wanted to sing. This card, it's a counter card, really good one for 1/1. Choose one of my death characters, it gains 3.5k for the turn. As a counter, 3.5k at level 1, really, really good. Combine that with her, she becomes 11k. Nothing at level 1 or 2 will punch over that. Well, most things will punch over that anyway. So that's my level 1s. Now, what's this? This is my level 2s. I'll move this over. Level 2s, I have 3 Kanade Worrying. This is a 2-1 assist, which Angel Beats really needed, and they got in the second extra booster. All the characters in front of this gains X plus X power, where X equals 500 times the level. So at worst, she doesn't boost level 0s. At best, she boosts for 1.5k for level 3s. And when she's placed from the hand to the stage, she gives another death character a 1k boost. Good assist. The deck really needed it. It's good. Up next is 2-1 Sheena. She is another counter. She's the third counter, the fourth counter of the deck. Level 2-1 for 2.5k backup. Her interesting effect is her first skill. When I use her backup, I can put all the cards in my waiting room back into my library. This can be a blessing and a curse. If you already milled out, or like have all your 8 climax cards in your waiting room, you can counter with her, put it back in, and hope to get a climax damage canceled. But sometimes it doesn't pay off. You all of a sudden like flood your deck with all the cards that you milled out. It's a win or lose card essentially. Never really get the chance to play her, but yep. Still recovering from a cold. I need to take some meds. 1:30 in the morning, yep. Need to take some medicine. Next I have another important card of the deck, Kanade Normal Girl. 4 of her. She's a 2-1 for 7.5k, not exciting, not as good as a 1-1 for 7.5k, but her effect is why I run her. She changes into Kanade Farewell Words, which is the level 3 Kanade, which I will show you in the near, which I will show you later. I'll just keep her aside, so I will show you what she changes into. Next I have 2-1 Otonashi Irregularity of the World. Puts a death character from my memory in the waiting room. Choose one of my characters in my waiting room, return it to the hand. He's another salvage card. 2-1 for 8k, not that bad. Like I said, salvage is always good. More salvage the better. Oh, not really more salvage the better, but you can return a key card that you need back to your hand when he plays. Actually, let me put him aside because there's an interesting combo between these two and the level 3. So this is the level 2s. These are level 3s. Alright, first I have 3-2 Kanade, Heart of Yuzu. When she is placed from hand to stage, put the top card of my clock in your waiting room, essentially heal. And when she battles another card, if she reverses that card, you send it to memory. I can send it to memory, which is really good for getting rid of problematic characters. Really good card for level 3. Good. I'm also running Yuri Solo Activities. I might switch her out. I don't know yet. Still in testing. When she's placed on the stage, she heals for 1. And she has a climax combo. If after the battle's in the climax zone, I may pay. Choose one character in my waiting room, return it to hand. Choose one of my death characters on the field. Gets a 3k boost. Until the end of my opponent's next turn. That's the only reason why I'm running her, because her climax combo is really, really good. Really, really good. Can't stress how good that is. Basically makes I can choose her, make her 13k during my opponent's turn. They can't punch over her, and she salvages. Good stuff. And now the card that combos with these six, Kanade Farewell Worlds. When it's summoned, I'm gonna use Yu-Gi-Oh terms. I don't care right now. When it's summoned, heal for 1, and she has another climax combo. If somewhere in some other time is placed in the climax zone, and this is the front row, I may send away an opponent's level 2 or lower characters into their stock. Not an extended climax combo, good for getting rid of problematic creatures. Done it a lot of times. Saved me a couple games because of it. Alright, so At level 2, she can change into her. So at level 2, you'll go from a 7.5k beater to a 10k beater for the cost of, what, 2 cards? Not even, 1 card. Because after she attacks, she builds a stock, spend that stock to bring her out. She puts herself, after she uses her effect, she puts herself to memory. Tonashi comes in. Because I can put a death character from my memory back into my waiting room. So if she gets put into memory, I can put her back into the waiting room. And his effect would then resolve, put it back into my hand, letting me change again for her. Pretty sick stuff. Pretty sick stuff, honestly. I'm sniffly. Ugh. And the last cards, as I said, are just the climaxes. I earn 2 after the battles. I have to cover Yuri's face because of the transition slips. Two Afterlife Battlefront. I might change that with this. Because I don't think I have any card that uses this as a climax combo. Three somewhere, some other time. The climax combo for Kanade Farewell Worlds. And 1 Time of Farewell, which is the climax combo for the 1-0. This is actually my first deck. I really like it. I like Angel Beats. I really like Angel Beats. My favorite anime right now. And yep. This is my Angel Beats deck. I think I'm eventually gonna build more decks. I actually do have another deck. And yeah, actually I have a could deck for could wafter. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe if you want to watch more Watch Watch related videos or any video game related videos. And while I'm at it, let me plug my other channel. I have a channel at twitch.tv/final11. That channel is where I play my video games. You can currently I'm playing Resident Evil 6, so you can watch me play RE6 there. Eventually, you're gonna play Assassin's Creed 3 when it comes out next week. Also, I will stream Watch Wars games there. I'll stream Yu-Gi-Oh games there, Vanguard games there, Magic games on it. So yeah, basically that's my random stream. I stream whatever I feel like streaming. If you want to watch it, great. More people watching it, the better I get, the better I feel. It's pretty fun there. And yeah, if anything, I'll put up an update on my channel saying when I'm going to post, when I'm going to start streaming Watch Wars. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe, comment, follow, whatever. Do whatever you want to do. And thanks for watching, guys. Pieces.